She's crazy. She's mean. She's lazy. She hits him. She doesn't cook. She doesn't clean. She talks back and she has a mouth on her. Their house is a mess. Their room is a mess. But he's so nice to her. He's so calm. He's so sweet. He's so quiet. He gives and does everything for her. Wow. Shame on her. Shame on her for doing all that. But most importantly, shame on her for not treating her husband like a wife or not supposed to. Because she should know better, right? Growing up as a girl in the Hmong culture, we were taught by our parents, especially our mother, to treat our husband with respect and to not do all the above. We were taught to be patient and to do everything that a wife or nya supposed to do. She's crazy, so he gets to be her. She doesn't cook, she doesn't clean, so he gets to be her. She's so lazy that their house is always a mess, so he gets to be her. Is all that okay then? And for all of you that are watching that saying there's no evidence of abuse, what about the holes in the wall? What about the uncle encouraging the husband to go ahead and hit her? And what about the simple fact that she had to go live on Facebook with all of this? Because we all know no one wants the whole world to know about the problems in our lives. Should this not be enough evidence to at least cause some concern? Well, it should be. I think as people, we need to stop shaming and blaming the victim and stop making excuses for the abuser. There should be other solutions to a problem instead of violence. I think in the year 2021, there has to be a better way. There must be a better way. There is a better way. What about communicating with each other? What about trying to understand each other? What about just helping and focusing on the relationship? And if all fails, what about counseling? In any relationship, both parties are equally responsible. And if one person is using violence as a solution to solve a problem, well, that person is in the wrong. Because violence should never be tolerated by any woman or men. And I believe as a younger generation, it is up to us to take control and change things so that these toxic patterns does not continue in our relationship or in our future generation. We must get the message out that if you are in a toxic relationship, you don't have to stay, that you don't have to be patient or oshende, that it's okay to leave for your own safety or to have a better life. My heart goes out to Nuli and to any person that is living with domestic violence. And I hope and pray that one day may they find the courage to walk away and know their self-worth.